cold as ice. Ice, ice, baby. Or anything else that fits with the theme of ice. You probably know what Pokemon will come next in the series of guides when we're talking about that kind of old-time music classics. Dear ladies and gentlemen, let me present to you Alolan Ninetales. Maybe our newest icy contestant for the top of the tier list? Who knows, but let's find it out. My name's Kay and welcome to my channel where we tackle everything about Pokemon Unite and other Nintendo games. Others already know what comes next. If you're new, hear me out and let's make a bet. If you finish watching this video, I'm totally sure that you will have learned effective strategies to win games with Alolan Ninetales. If that's the case, you owe me a subscription and a big icy like. Hey, it's free, and besides good strategies for the game with your favorite icy fox, you also get more guides, tips and tricks. Deal? Deal. With that said, we're getting down to it. Have fun and let's start the guide. Let's have a closer look at Alolan Ninetales. The difficulty is intermediate and it's a ranged attacker, which attacks with special attack damage. 4-star in offense, and that's the main trait. What we're gonna use Alolan Ninetales for? Making some humongous damage. Let's have a closer look at the evolution line and the moves we have at our disposal. We are starting out with the cute Alolan Vulpix and level 1 and evolve at level 4 to Alolan Ninetales. And the first two moves we can choose between are on the one side Powder Snow and on the other side Icy Wind. Powder Snow attacks with a chilly gust of powdery snow in front of us, which decreases the movement speed of opposing Pokemon for a short time when it hits. And Icy Wind attacks with a gust of freezing air and dealing damage to opposing Pokemon in the area of the effect, which also decreases the movement speed for a short time when it hits. Let's start with Powder Snow. Powder Snow is mostly the ability I take first. Why? Because we have some AoE, attack, range and possibilities, so we can hit the A-pumps multiple times, or in this case both A-pumps, to clear the lane a little bit faster and to get to the neutral spawn in the middle of the lane. The second attack of course is Icy Wind, and you see the range is quite far and you can push the Pokemon a little bit away and hit it with ice and slow it down. At level 4 we not only evolve, we also get the first improved move, and we can choose between Avalanche and Dazzling Gleam. Avalanche is an attack where we attack with a gush of chilly ice toward the designated area. This ice forms a wall that cannot be passed, and enemy Pokemon get hit as soon as the wall melts. The attack gets upgraded on level 11 to Avalanche Plus, which also decreases the movement speed of the opposing Pokemon for a short time when the move hits. Dazzling Gleam is an attack in a powerful cone with blinding light, which leaves opposing Pokemon unable to act when this move hits them. Also on level 11 we get Dazzling Gleam Plus, which increases the damage which is dealt and the length of the time the opposing Pokemon is unable to act. With the evolution to level 4 we can choose Avalanche. You see Avalanche has a quite far range, we hit in a straight line with the ice and at the end the ice wall gets built up and at the end destroys and makes some damage to the enemies. Like we see here, it goes up and in the AoE range where the wall is, we make additional damage, and with the plus variant we also can slow down the enemies. When we reach level 4 we of course can also take Dazzling Gleam. You see the attack is based on a cone and when it hits, all the enemies are unable to act for a short while, and so we can stun them in position and use the damage of our Pokemon or of course of our team to try to leave them out of the battle. I haven't hit in this case, but you see it's quite a nice short stun which helps you to CC the enemy a bit, to control the field a bit more, and that's one of the attacks I mostly use in my combination, with the second attack coming later up. The next move already comes at level 6 and you see it's quite quick with the evolution, also with the attacks. We have on the one side Blizzard and on the other side Aurora Veil. When attacking with Blizzard we summon a name-giving Blizzard which hits with two blasts in front of the user. The first blast deals on the one side damage to the opposing Pokemon in the area of the effect and also of course decreases the movement speed. You see the decreased movement speed is a kind of returning thing for Alolan Ninetales in this case. And the second blast deals damage to the opposing Pokemon in the area of effect and shoves them away. If the second blast hits an obstacle, it also deals damage to opposing Pokemon near the point of impact. Blizzard Plus will be unlocked at level 13 and increase the damage dealt by this move. And Aurora Veil is a buff which creates an aura around Alolan Ninetales that reduces the damage which is received, and all ally Pokemon in this area get the effect too. While we are in this cone, or in this aura more to say, the movement speed is increased and the basic attacks always become boosted attacks. On level 13, we get Aurora Veil Plus, which further reduces the damage ally Pokémon receive. Blizzard is the second ability you should choose when playing with Avalanche. Why? Because with Avalanche you can create a wall, and with Blizzard you can shove the enemy Pokémon into the wall and use the bonus effect that it deals additional AoE damage to opposing Pokémons in the area. So Avalanche, a Blizzard, and so you can make quite a lot of bit of damage, which is very, very cool. Now let's have a look at Aurora Veil. Like we said, it's a buff, so we can place it down on the ground, and you see it below the health bar of Alolan Ninetales, all the attacks are boosted. Again, it's always the yellow part of the attack, so every attack is boosted and deals the additional AoE damage. And don't forget, increased movement speed, we are more defended because we don't take as much damage, and the effect also helps our friendly teammates to make this same. This is really, really good, and in combination with Dazzling Gleam, where we can hit enemies, stun them, push Aurora Veil, and then make even more damage with boosted attacks. That's the combination I run mostly, and it's very effective on the field. And finally, on level 9, we unlock the Unite move Snow Globe. With Snow Globe, we attack with a Chilly Snow and Ice, which deals damage to opposing Pokémon in the area of the effect when the move hits. It deals increased damage to opposing Pokémon that are frozen. And at level 9, we get the Unite move. And with it, we can press it in action, have a quite large AoE radius, do a little bit, or in this case, lots of damage to all the enemies in the area, and let's do it again. You see, it hits, and so we can clear up a huge field of enemies if they are here, and that's quite interesting when we're fighting against Dreadnought, or of course against Zapdos in the last 2 minutes. We of course also have a passive ability, in this case it's Snow Warning, which causes snow to fall on opposing Pokémon, which deals damage to them, and the passive also decreases the movement speed for a short time. Boosted attack moves, except Aurora Veil at itself, sling snow, and if we hit enemy Pokémon multiple times, a little snowflake will appear above their heads, and if we hit multiple times, the Pokémon will get frozen for a short time. And the basic attack is also boosted with every third hit. When the boosted attack hits, it deals damage to nearby opposing Pokémon, and of course, like Alolan Ninetales likes it, decreases the movement speed again for a short time. Let's have a look in action with Alolan Ninetales. As you've seen, that was the passive ability, hitting with snow from the sky, and also the basic attack. Three attacks, third attack is boosted, dealing additional damage and then slowing down the enemy. What can we say about Alolan Ninetales and the moveset? I for my part use mostly Aurora Veil and Dazzling Gleam, like I said in the attack descriptions, so you can stun enemies and hit them with the Aurora Veil boosted attack bonus, help your teammates, and so try to control the team fights at points like Dreadnought and Zapdos. But of course you also can use Avalanche and Blizzard, because the combination of creating a wall and hitting the enemies with Blizzard, shoving them against it, and then dealing additional AoE damage with the really far range can be very effective if used correctly to snipe Zapdos and so maybe turn the match. You know what comes next, the battle items. And of course, also in this case, and based on the actual meta, I can always recommend Eject Button. We can dash away, we have a time where we can escape enemy attacks, and that's just amazing. And to be honest, there aren't as many interesting choices we can take here. Maybe you can take Gold Getter if you try to make goals faster, but to be honest, Eject Button is the way to go, and I recommend you to use it. And you know, when we're talking about battle items, it's also time to talk about the question of the day. And in this case, my question is, which Pokémon do you like in its Alolan form more? For me, it's quite interesting because it's Alolan Ninetales, because Vulpix and Ninetales were one of my favorite Pokémon from the first generation, and it's really glamorous and beautiful to see that they changed the type to Ice, and the Pokémon looks just amazing. So tell me what's your favorite Alolan form, I'm very interested to see in the comments. Write it down below and let me know. And of course we also have the health items, and in the actual times there is a combination I can recommend for almost every Pokémon, and I use it too on Alolan Ninetales. Let's have a look. The first item is Muscle Band. Why? Because with the combination of Aurora Veil, we get increased basic attack speed, and you know, when we're inside the circle, we get a buff where every attack gets boosted. So the 5% in this case means in raw numbers, we can attack 5% faster and hit with all these boosted attacks. The second one is focus band. You know, defense is increased as well as special defense. And for 3 seconds, we get 14% because the item is on level 20 per tick back. It's a very good item at the moment. You have more survivability and it helps you, especially in the early game and also in situations where maybe the fight seems to be lost and you can get back on your feet. And of course, body barrier. The HP boost is very nice. And when you use the Unite move, it's also impressive to get a shield for yourself and of course the Pokemon with the lowest HP value in your nearest field. This combination of items is very, very good, but of course you can play Alolan Ninetales a little bit more like a glass cannon. So in this case, you can replace Focus Band with the Wise Glasses, where you get a flat amount of special attack bonus and of course a percentage wise increase, so you get more punch with your moves. And also in this case, you can, if you want, but I wouldn't recommend it, replace Body Barrier. As I said, if you want to play it even more glass cannon, you can check the special attack specs, which increases special attack by a flat amount and increases the special attack every time we score a goal. Now we've taken a look at the attacks, at the evolution and all the items we should use with Alolan Ninetales. You know, in this section I'm going to show you some scenes of recent gameplays of mine, where I will show you how you can use the moves most effectively and what's important to know. So, no more words, let's start right into it. That's a perfect use case for Dazzling Gleam and Aurora Veil. You see, we have 3 enemies there, we stun them briefly and hit with the boosted attacks and can get, including the Unite attack, 2 of them. Machamp is trying to get away but again is stunned with the Unite move of Cinderace, and so we've cleared the fight for Dreadnought. Again, 2 enemies are here. You see Aurora Veil on the ground, we are all getting boosted attacks, Dazzling Gleam helps us stun them and then we can KO both of them. One more situation in this case, controlling Zapdos, we attacking with Gleam, stunning, and the Greninja doesn't stand a chance to get away with the boosted attacks, gets smacked down, and so we can secure the area for us. And in this scene, you can see how much sustain we get with this combination. Even with stun locked, we get back to the goal, have the enemies there, nobody's down, we can stun them with every hit, almost down, we get back to the goal, heal up again, our team has time to come back and help us in this situation, we can stun them, they are still in the clear of us, and with the boosted attacks, all getting beaten down, and that's how we've secured the situation and how we can get back down to Dreadnought. That's a good case for Blizzard and Avalanche. You see Lucario's trying to get away, Avalanche is the attack to stun him, freeze him, give him some punch with the team, so he gets down, and we almost got Crossland Gengar too, so it's a very good attack combination to control the field. And again, Avalanche and Blizzard in action. We jump to the second goal, and with both moves, we can control the enemies. Lucario is so much slowed down, so he doesn't stand a chance to get away, and our Lucario helps to secure the KO. And the last moment, we see Avalanche and Venusaur. With it, we can freeze it. Blizzard shoves it into a wall. We have AoE damage. It doesn't stand a chance. Both of the enemies getting down in the team fight, and we can go down to Zapdos and hopefully get it. In the truest sense of the word, we make the knees of our opponents shake. Whether it's the combination of stun and the continuous bombardment of boosted attacks with Dazzling Gleam and Aurora Veil, or the variant of the huge range and the bonus AoE damage from Avalanche and Blizzard. Alolan Ninetales is a ranged attacker that offers a number of ways to play the Pokémon, and there is something for every playstyle. Because of the top attacks and the resulting effectiveness in its role, Alolan Ninetales gets an anime wow from me. Now there's only one thing left to clarify. You didn't think I forgot about our deal, did you? If you found the video helpful, I would be incredibly happy and thankful about a like and a subscription. You will get more content and guides for Pokémon Unite, and with your support, we can grow the channel to bring even more people into the community. Alright, so there's not much left to say except thanks for being part of it. My name's Kay, and see you soon.